Hey guys, welcome back to the next video. This time it is the NFA 14 Gen 2. Brand new PWM fans from Noctua. Okay then guys, these are the brand new fans from Noctua. The NFA 14s Gen 2. Now, these are brand new. They've just come out. They did release these, of course, on the NHD15 G2. New cooler they just brought as well. Now what it says in the box, it says further optimized G2 technologies, Sterux liquid crystal polymer compound, and then it says highly optimized P and Q curve. So let's have a look what's inside the box, shall we? Now when you first open the box, you are greeted with this, tells you the technical backgrounds, tells you what bearing it is and stuff like that, but we'll get into that right now. Comes with a little accessory box, but we'll get to that in a minute. And then it comes with this little piece of paper that tells you, caution, that is a high precision device with extremely strict tolerances. Therefore, it is crucial to avoid excessive forces acting into the frame, especially when installing the fan to a water radiator. So it does come with these little grommets for the sides. We will have a look now while we do that. Now, something I will say about this is the overall packaging is just premium. It's just got a premium feel. It feels absolutely fantastic. There's a bit more information. Then we got the fan. Now it does come in this little protector here that is so that the fins do not rotate during transit, because a lot of fans, when they start rotating in transit, that's when the fluid or anything that's to do with the bearing inside will start to leak, and that's where fans generally die. It's a 4-pin PWM, and of course it does come in this gasket here. This is primarily for radiator installations. It's just so it helps with the overall gaps, because they have engineered this fan for years. It's been in development for I think 10 years, so it's been very exciting to actually look at these fans. These are the specifications. Okay, these are the specs. That's what tells you it comes inside the box. This is what the rotational speed does without an adapter and with LNA. So that's the rated speed, 1500 RPM, and then it's 1250. The airflow is by there, 155.6, and then it's 127.1 with LNA. The overall noise is rated for 24.8 decibels with a 19.7 decibels with LNA. And then the start pressure is 2.56. That's without the adapter. And then with, I'm assuming with the adapter, it's 1.3. So you're actually losing a bit of start pressure there, but it will make sure to reduce the noise. So that's the power output. That's the overall input power. That's the volts, 12, and then that is what they rate it for continuous use, 150,000 hours, and that is the overall warranty. You can actually scan that to get the manual, but what I'm going to do now is show you what comes in the box. And then you're greeted with the fan, very gorgeous fan. I like the colour scheme, I never used to, but actually seeing it in person, there's a major difference in it, so you've probably seen him on Linus Tech Tips' channel or not. He's used them in a build. But here, the adapters. It comes with a low noise adapter. Comes with an extension cable. And then it does come with a splitter. This is to control more than one fan. And then these are what I was on about. These are actually anti-dampening grommets. What you do is you put these in instead of the metal screws, which they do provide. But these will stop vibrations in the case. And then, of course, then you've got more rubber grommets for the inside and the outside. This is just for primarily stopping noise. They are really focused when it comes to noise this time, and I'm all for that. Now let's get this installed. I will be testing this out on an AIO, because it's the only way I find that I get the best results, because you're isolating the fans from the case, so you know that's where it helps. Now the 5900X, but it will be on a 280 millimeter radiator. So let's get these gorgeous fans installed. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is the NFA1 4x22 G2 PWM fans from Noctua. Now I'm going to put the mic up towards the fans and pull away. This is a 50% fan speed. Barely heard it at 50%. Same thing, but a 100% fan speed. Yes, you can hear them at 100%, but still very quiet. Okay then, so when it comes to the overall benchmarking, now I'm running my normal runner test, Cinebench R23, Blender Pavilion, Blender Classroom, and 3D Mark Z test. Now, when it comes to the overall room temp, the room temp at the time of testing was 16 Celsius, and after testing, it did go up by 2 Celsius. Now, for CPU power, the CPU power draw during the tests was 200 watts, and the lows it went down to was 182. Now, when it comes to CPU clocks, the CPU clocks were 4.9, but did go down to 4.2, but that's well above base clocks, you haven't got to worry. Now, when it comes to RPM, the RPM of 50% is 750 RPM. So, for Cinebench R23, the idles are 27 with a max of 85. Blender Pavilion, idles, 27 with a max of 84. Blender Classroom, idles, 27 with a max of 83. And 3D Mark Supertest, idles, 27 with a max of 77 Celsius. Okay, so for 100% fan speed, now the CPU power did go up a bit. It went up to 202 watts and the lows it went down to was 188 watts. The clocks were exactly the same, 4.9 and did go down to 4.2, but that's well above base clocks, so I'm going to worry. So when it comes to the overall RPM of 100%, it is 1500 RPM. So for Cinebench R23, idles 26 already went down by 1 degree and max 83. Blender Pavilion, idles 26 with a max of 82. Blender Classroom, idles 26 with a max of 82. And 3D Mark Supertest, idles 26 with a max of 75 Celsius. Now what I'm going to do right here is actually put up a separate graph showing you what the performance difference is between thermal take as well as be quiet. And I'll just put a graph right here so you can actually see. I've run the exact same tests on all three fans. So all three brands, so this is where you'll get the comparisons and see which one you should actually buy. Okay, and so what do you think? Now what I'm going to tell you is these fans are very quiet, they perform very well, but there's one problem I have, and that would be the pricing. These are £35 a fan, or for a two-pack £70. Now that's quite expensive for a fan, but what I will tell you is you're getting your money's worth when it comes to the overall quality. The overall quality of these fans is absolutely amazing. These are probably one of the best quality fans I've actually ever had through Welchie Tech, and that's saying something, seeing as I've had Be Quiet fans through here as well. They're pro line. So what I will tell you is you're getting your money's worth, but I still think that the price is very high. But whether you or Noctua agree, that's completely up to you. That's just my personal and honest opinion. I think the pricing is a little bit high. Now, when it comes to these fans, as you're probably aware, with the air cooler as well, they've been in development for years. So that's where some of the price will actually come, because they put a lot of R&D into it. So that's probably the price. But like I just said, that's your opinion. Whether you agree with me or not, that's up to you completely. Now, I do like the fans. They're very quiet. The performance is fantastic. The overall build quality, the overall packaging, it's just screamed premium and overall quality. Now, if you want to buy any of these, I will make sure to leave links for the single packs as well as the dual packs. And that'll be for overclockers as well as Amazon. So whether you want to buy it or not, just make sure you use my link. It gives me a kickback for the work I do, especially on reviews, especially fan reviews, because there's a lot that does go into them. Now, for future content coming, make sure you subscribe, because I've got a lot of stuff here. I've got the QNAP server to do, which I will be starting on very soon. I've got new stuff here from Thermalright. I've got more stuff here from Thermal Grizzly. I've got more stuff coming from PC Cooler. And I'm working on things with Be Quiet. They're sending me the new 600 light base case, as well as the Lightloop AIO. So make sure you subscribe for that. And as always, this is Rich from Welsh Tech. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you have a fantastic weekend and week ahead of you. So, goodbye.